sound of the music should be different in indoor and outdoor shoots with music. We hear the music we listen to indoors differently when we go outside the venue. For example, while music plays normally inside the car, the sound heard outside the car is more bassy and the music sound muffled. So, in this tutorial, I will try to show you how to achieve this muffled sound. Let's get started. I've added two videos to the workspace and I've also added some bassy music. One video is from outside the car and the other is from inside the car. But it is not the same car. Let's not get too hung up on that. Let's quickly set up the scene. First, we see the car from outside. Then we see the car from inside. Then again from the outside and again from the inside. We will arrange the music accordingly. Let me do it quickly. We created our workspace. While the car is giving a view from the outside, we suddenly see the inside view. Then we see the outside again and see the inside again. Every time we see the outside, we will give this effect we want to give to the music. We will only put the bass and try to make it look like music is playing in the car, but only the bass is reflected outside. So, we also need to separate the music. So, we need to separate the line with the clips on top. I press Alt on the keyboard and it goes to the first frame of the next clip. If you don't have it here, probably this is inactive. If I press it like this, it will only go to the last frame or the first frame on the clip whose blue color is active. So, when I turn this on, I will be able to switch on these clips. Right now, I'm pressing the up key on the keyboard and it goes to the first frame of this clip. I press it again and it goes to the last frame of this clip. I press it again and it goes to the first frame and so on. Now, I'm in the first frame of this clip. I get the razor tool, shortcut C. When I click on that, I'll cut it. I'm marking here. This is cut. The music here is now independent of this. Now, let's do the same for this one. Let's go to the first frame of this clip. The last frame is already cut. Now, I take the arrow tool again, and as you can see, I can select this one separately. I can also select this one separately. I can also select these separately. So, that means we can add effects to each of these. This means that the music effect we added to this outdoor space will not be used in this one. It will not be affected by it. After roughly preparing our scene in this way, we will add effects, so that we can better understand the difference. It continues like this. Now let's apply the effect, which is the main topic of the video. If you don't see the effect panel here, make sure that effects under window is selected. We will type parametric equalizer here. I am adding the parametric equalizer effect to the exterior sound. In other words, I am adding it to the external sound of the vehicle. I've added it here. We will make some edits in the effect controls panel about the effect we have added. Again, if you don't see the effects control panel, you need to check the effects control option under window. After selecting the sound, I direct the effect to. You will see the parametric equalizer option here. Below this, you will usually see these options when adding sound effects in Premiere. When I click edit here, a separate window opens where you can edit that effect for that sound. This is the window of parametric equalizer. Let's come to the presets here and select the low pass option. When I select low pass, you will see just a dot. When you direct this dot here towards the center, now listen to the sound and you will understand the difference very well. Let's move the window over here. As you can see, while we are looking from the outside, at the same time there was a feeling that the sound was coming from inside the car. You can reach the most accurate result by moving this point in this direction according to your own video and music. I think I've explained the low pass logic. And now, we are going to apply the same to the other one to complete the clip. So, we will apply it to this one as well. We can do the same thing again and drag it here from the effects panel and make the same settings again. But that's not necessary. We can just copy the effect we have already done and let it come here. I select the effect we just did and copy it with Ctrl+C. I hover over this audio file and paste it with Ctrl+V. As you can see, we have the same effect here as we just did. Now let's watch the project again from the beginning. This part is too much. I'm quickly cutting the end of this part. And I'm playing the project from start to finish. In this Premiere tutorial, we focused on sound. Since the sound of the music should be different from each other in indoor and outdoor shots of two videos with music, I tried to show the sound, especially in the outdoor sound, the sound coming from a distance and reflecting more muffled, not as much as inside. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.